Good morning, Danny boy.
Morning, Mother.
Homie boy looking so sweet this morning.
Mr. Wells, never come and see me in the office till 10 o'clock. I'm going to eat and wait right there.
But I feel this, father. You better watch your head.
Well, you see, once today.
Danny, I run short of cocoa this morning. So I'll give you some orange tea.
That is all right, ma'am.
See, so hanging on that show of girl Carl Parker living down the road.
Who told you so?
I don't have to tell you that. Me and mine, you know, as I tell you, as long as I have to do for sake, you only there.
You're so kind to me, eh? All these meals since I'm not working. As soon as I get work, I'll give you something.
Sometimes I wish you wouldn't work, because you will let me go.
All that tonight, maybe.
You know that Papa George come behind me last night?
He was drunk.
Not so bad, but he had enough to you, and he got real stupid. There again and crying and talking about how he could dead if he don't get. So I feel sorry for him.
I find he too fresh for a woman.
One thing with him is whenever I shot a cat, he just gives me a good reason.
You said it is a nice neighbor.
Thanks for the complimentary. But Danny, don't let Atterwell talk you into leaving Calabash Alley.
What do you mean?
Businessman smart too bad. He won't call you to see him if he didn't have something to gain. But whatever it is, don't leave the alley to go any other place.
I can't see how that could be the case.
Another thing, don't bring Shirley Wells back in the barracks.
I said nothing like that.
Wait, is then?
You know. All I know, I keep my fingers crossed, and I'm not taking them out until things go in my way.
I didn't know that young people believe in them things.
My grandmother teach me that, and I'll never forget it.
Well, Danny boy, I with you. I crossing mine too.
Sir, a man by the name of Danny came in here to see you. He says he has an appointment, but nothing is recorded here. Yes? Yes? All right, I'll send him in now. Mr. King, Mr. Wells will see you now. Just push that door, go straight ahead until you see a doormat manager. Simply knock and enter.
Thank you.
Ah, good morning, Danny. Have a seat.
Morning, sir.
Miss Small, would you tell George in the cafeteria to send up 2 cups of coffee, please?
I don't drink coffee, mister.
What then, a coffee?
That neither. It has given too much gas. Any kind of juice will be okay.
Miss Small, tell him to send up 1 cup of coffee and 1 glass of fruit juice. Any kind will be all right. Yes, I'm glad you came. Relax. Make yourself comfortable. You're not in a hurry, are you?
No, I have plenty of time.
Yes, Danny. Guess what? I always remember that day you came to see Shirley.
I just tried to forget that day.
I just said, take it, Brutus. And he had you jumping over the fence and running down the road like mad. I laughed my head off. But afterwards, I realized how cruel I was. Really, I didn't have anything much against you. But my wife, she couldn't stand the sight of you. The way you walk, the way you talk, the way you dress, the place you lived in, everything.
Yes. I know how it was, sir. But I was in love with your daughter.
You still feel the same way about her?
I think so. She's special. And I could tell because I had lots of girls.
How do you do that?
What?
Get girls so easily.
I don't know. Just lucky, that's all.
Wish I had a bit of your luck. Where are you working now?
Working? I'm without a job for months now.
Want a job?
Yes, sweet.
I thought perhaps you were the sweet man type who like a woman to mind you and you just pose around the place.
Not me, sir. I like to stand on my own two legs. You could get a job from me, sir?
Sure, Dan. Right now, I need a messenger in my department.
Messenger?
What's wrong with that?
Well, it's not the kind of job I like to do.
You can't be too choosy about a job when you have none at all. Many young fellas take the job, and when they get something better, they move on.
Sir, I have to wear uniform?
Not anymore. There was a time just recently when G. Goldman and Company used to insist that uniforms be worn. But just dress as you are now, or you can wear a nice shirt, as long as you are clean and tidy. No jeans or jerseys.
Nice. How much is the pay?
I think it is about $600 a fortnight, with a few extra dollars for transport.
What? I'll take it.
Thank you, Mr. Small.
Notice anything?
What?
About her?
No.
I know you didn't notice. She was trying to attract your attention. She was all smiles and pleasantness. It really amazes me how some men can bring about such changes in women. Go ahead, darling. Fruit juice for you.
Ah, nice. What were you talking about?
The job, sir. What do I really have to do?
Well, I'm excited to post letters or to collect documents for contracts from certain firms for equipment. Or to the bank to deposit money, you know, the usual errands about the place.
That's all, sir?
Well, you will have to go up and down the building several times to different floors for information. For instance, I may even send you with a message to Carol Parker downstairs.
Carol Parker?
Yes, our mutual friend, Carol Parker. You look shocked.
Well, I know she was working here, but I didn't know I would have any dealings with her.
That should make you happy.
Why, sir?
Oh, come on, Danny. Don't pretend. You love her.
Love her? I hardly know her.
But you all were laughing and enjoying yourselves last night playing cards?
That don't mean a thing. I just enjoy my game with anybody.
Look, Danny. I know I've given you a raw deal when you were coming around my daughter. And you should hate my guts. And I don't deserve any sympathy from you. But I want to tell you this. Although it will sound ridiculous, but I love that girl. I will do anything for her. She is everything to me. I think about her all the time. I just can't get out of my mind.
But, Mr. Wells, she's about half your age.
That is what is so stupid about the whole thing, Danny. Danny, when I was about your age, the boss in my department was about 50-something. He had his wife and about 4 or 5 big sons and daughters. Yet, he was madly in love with a young girl who used to work in the cafeteria. You should see how that man used to get on when she was around. I used to think it so foolish for a big man like that. Then one of the younger fellas started giving some competition, and she started to treat the boss bad. Guess what happened?
The boss fired the young man?
No. The boss was driving his car one day, and he knocked down the young man, who died a few days after in hospital. The lawyer's managed to pass it off as an accident.
He lucky to get away.
But that isn't all. A few months after the case, the boss somehow or other managed to get the young girl to go for a drive with him. And an argument must have started. And the car ran over a cliff on the way to Las Vegas. And both of them died.
Sorry to say this, sir. But a big educated man, he really looked it. So much a woman all about the place.
Take on that. That is exactly what I said when I was your age. Now, I really shouldn't be telling you this. But I actually find myself suffering. Suffering pain. Because this girl refused to have anything to do with me.
Sir, I hope you don't mind I saying this. But Carol is a flighty sort of girl. Running from man to man.
I know that. I know I will lose my good name if I should live in a house with her. But I can't help it. I left my home, my wife and my daughter. And I'm now living a lonely life, all by myself. I just don't know what to do. I just don't want to get violent, that is all.
Sir, if there's anything that I can do, I'm willing to help.
You'll do what I ask?
Yeah, sure.
Stop seeing Carol.
Stop seeing Carol?
That's all I'm asking.
But that won't solve it.
It will hurt her. Because you might be the first man to turn her down. And she won't be able to stand it. And then,
what?
She may come back to me.
Carol says she'll come back to you if you go back with your wife.
That I will never do. Look, Dad. Stop seeing Carol.
Okay. If you feel that will work.
As a deal?
Thanks, Mr. Wells. When do I start to work?
Well, I will give you a letter right now to take to a form about something. Thank you.